Good evening. You are watching Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi with Rajya Sabha News. Let's begin the bulletin with the headlines. Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu starts a new tradition, places before people an account of the functioning of the upper house in the last 5 years, highlights dysfunctional pattern that caused legislative output of the house to fall drastically in comparison to 2004 and 2009. Rajya Sabha passes motion of thanks to President Kovind's address before House adjourns, sign it aye. And CAG report on capital acquisition in the Indian Air Force tabled in the Rajya Sabha. Report compares 2007 and 2015 purchase agreement using the price of 18 fighters that were to be bought in a flyaway condition in the 2017. Rajya Sabha was adjourned sine die on Wednesday after a 13-day long budget session. The upper house passed 5 bills, including interim budget and finance bill for 2019-20, without debate on the last day of the session. Asserting that even legislatures are accountable to the people, Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu presented a report to the people on the performance of the upper house during the last 5 years. He expressed concern over the low productivity of 4.90% during the budget session. Expressing happiness over passing of 5 bills on the last day of the session, he added that the practice of passing bills without discussion is better avoided.
Leader of the opposition, Sri Gulam Nabi Ji, leaders of various parties, members of the August House, as we come to closure of at another session, where at the moment of Honorable Prime Minister, where the moment of reflection, a stock taking of what we have achieved and what we have not. With a heavy heart, I have to say that this short but important budget session of the Rajya Sabha turned out to be another wasted opportunity. This only reinforces the dysfunctional pattern that has been evident for the last few years, in which a matter of serious concern, and it will be a big challenge to the democracy. It's time for all sections of the House to evolve a collective consciousness to enable effective functioning of the House, further to deep introspection to prevent any further damage to the standing of this August House, which is also known as the House of Elders. Elders are usually expected to show the way to others. This was the earnest hope with which I began this session. The optimist tells me, even now, not to lose the hope and instead wait for a turnaround. I only hope that this would sooner than later will happen. Parliamentary democracy is all about ensuring governance through accountability to the people, the ultimate patrons and the ultimate masters. It is not only the accountability of the executive to be ensured by the legislatures, but the accountability of the legislature and the judiciary as well. What about the accountability of the legislatures and their failures to discharge the mandate of functions? Rajya Sabha, as the second chamber of affects legislature, too is accountable to the people. Its performance rankles me quite a bit. This session being the last one before the general election, fast approaching, we need to know as to what extent this August House lived up to the role and expectations of the people. I would like to report to the people what all we have been able to do. The legislature and executive have a bounden duty of doing the needful, responding to the wishes and aspirations of the people as conveyed in their mandate in general election. All the members of this August House would be well aware of three critical functions of legislature: legislative, deliberative and accountability functions. We all supposed to make legislations necessary for the betterment of the country and the people, take up and deliberate on issues of public importance and ensure the accountability of government of the day. Evidence suggests that we did not rise to the expectation of the people. So as a chairman of the House, the custodian of the House and members' rights and responsibilities, I hope that everyone will realize the same and then move forward for better performance in future. Since June 2014, Rajya Sabha held 18 sessions and 329 sittings till today and passed only 149 bills. This comes to a less than a bill in two sittings. The bills passed during this period is 39, less than the 188 bills passed during 2009 and 14, and an astonishing 63 bills lesser than 251 bills passed by this House during 2004 and 9. These statistics clearly show that the legislative output of this House has substantially declined since 2014. Question hour is primarily meant to ensure accountability of the executive of the day. Calling attention notices, short duration discussions, besides zero hour and the provision for making special pensions are meant for raising issues of public importance and concern. But we had shown respect for the same. Every question hour lost means an opportunity of seeking answers from the government on 8 issues of policy, implementation and governance by 40 members. Every 0 hour lost means depriving 15 members raising their immediate issues of importance. Since June 2014, the productivity of the August House in terms of the time available and the time utilized for taking up the legislative business and issues of public concern is only 60%. Who is to be held accountable for this? We all have to ponder over this. Of the 18 sessions over the last 5 years, the productivity of the House has been below the 5-year average of 60% in respect of 9 sessions. In terms of bills passed, it ranged from just one bill in the case of inter-session of 2016 and the budget session of 2018, 2 bills passed during the monsoon session of 2015, to a maximum of 14 bills each passed during the monsoon session of 16 and 18. While the sittings of the House as per the year during the last 5 years have been as per the trend of 60 to 70 days, the declining productivity of legislature output is a matter of deep concern. A large number of bills are pending consideration of the House, and you all know what are those bills. I need not enumerate them. During the last 5 sessions, I have had the honor of presiding over. A total of 28 bills have been passed during the 88 sittings, which comes to less than a bill in 3 sittings. While the 3 bills were passed during the last winter session, this budget session proved to be far less productive. This session and the last one has witnessed heightened efforts by some section of the House to force this August House into a kind of suspended animation. This has forced me to name some numbers, not to my liking, but at the same time as I was mandated to do my responsibility. I was worried about the public perception about the state of affairs in this House. Further, logical action could not be taken, as some senior leaders assured me that they would talk it out with the concerned parties and members and convince them not to disrupt the House any further. But it did not happen, unfortunately. I have made my best possible efforts to enable normal functioning of the House. I have been regularly talking to leaders of various parties, but my anguish seems to have no impact. This only exposed the limitations of the chair in altering the scripts of some sections of the House. So this is really very unfortunate. As the honourable members, I have set up a 2-member committee to examine the existing provisions of the rules of business of the House in terms of their adequacy to enable smooth functioning of the House. This report has been received and the same soon will be referred to General Purpose Committee of the House. I would like the committee to take a final view on the recommendations so that they could be made effective before the next full session of the House. Honourable members, ultimately this August House would be what you want it to be. A performing one or a dysfunctional one, the choice is to the members. People of the country want it to be a performing one. So let us all keep in mind the expectations of the people and try to live up to the expectations. During this budget session, with 10 sittings as against the available total time of 48 hours, more than 44 hours has been lost due to disruptions. Productivity of the House during this session has been 4.9%. Honourable members, the looming prospect of this session ending up without passing any bill has been thankfully averted by late realization and some understanding today. As a result, 5 bills have been passed, 3 bills have been passed, including that finance 3 bills. 5 bills have been. But I suggest that the practice of passing bills without discussion is better avoided. I agree with the members also. 6 bills have been introduced during this session. 16 zero-hour submissions could be taken up during this session and no special mentions at all. But we all agree that it is not enough. I hope the report to the people on the functioning of the House during the last 5 years will be taken serious note of it. As a chairman, I have a responsibility to convey to the country and its people about the performance of the House. Members of this August House are elected by those elected by the people. You are supposed to demonstrate higher sense of responsibility and ensure normal functioning of the House guided by the people's concern and their expectations. So each one of us seriously think if we can collectively enhance the quality of debate, discussions and most importantly, debonair. If we can follow the procedures and use available parliamentary tools, the hopes and aspirations of the people are expected to articulate will be heard. If cacophony and disruptive spectacles become our House characteristic, we would have betrayed the people's trust in each one of us. I do hope we don't allow further downslide in the coming days. Despite all the shortcomings, my dear members, the last 5 years, the Rajya Sabha passed a few path-breaking bills, positively impacting the socio-economic development of the country. Besides checking corruption and improving transparency, they include the Constitution 124th Amendment Bill 2019, providing 10% reservation for economically weaker sections. The Constitution 122nd Amendment Bill 2014 for the introduction of GST and 9 other related bills. Third, the Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribe Prevention of Atrocities Amendment Bill 2015 and 2018. Fourth, the Criminal Law Amendment Bill 2018 to prevent sexual abuse of children. Five, the Fugitive Economic Offenders Bill 2018. The Prevention of Corruption Amendment Bill 2018. Six, seven, the Black Money, Undisclosed Foreign Income and Assets and Imposition of Tax Bill 2015. Eight, the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code 2016 and the Related Amendment Bill 2017. Nine, the Constitution 123rd Amendment Bill 2017 for setting up a National Commission for Backward Classes. 10. The Real Estate Regulation, RERA, Bill 2016 to protect the interest of buyers and enhance the confidence in and credibility of the important real estate sector. 11. The Mines and Minerals Development and Regulation Amendment Bill 2015 and 2016, besides the Coal Mines Special Provisions Bill 2015 for auctioning of the mines. 12. The Aadhaar Targeted Delivery of Financial and Other Subsidies, Benefits and Service Bill 2016. The 13, the Child Labour Prohibition and Regulation Amendment Bill 2016. 14, the Commercial Courts, Commercial Divisions and Commercial Appellate Division of High Courts Bill 2015. And 15, the Rights of Persons with a Disability Bill 2016. Honourable members, that we should all take care of the perception that is going, and we must see to it that in the coming days that we improve our performance. I can only say obstruction of proceedings cannot be allowed to emerge as the preferred form of parliamentary democracy. Our nation has just entered the 70th year of Republic legislature, and the honourable members should discharge their noble responsibilities. As House of Elders, we need to lead by example. This is a privilege that the people bestowed on you. The expectations are very high. Our responsibilities are onerous. We can ill afford to regret our last opportunities we had. We must script a new chapter next time we meet, and we meet a new chapter which we can all be proud in the coming days. Honourable members may keep this in mind. Though not a very productive session, I would like to thank all the members at least for this today's concluding day on a positive note. That's a good thing that has happened. So, my honourable members, I have enumerated all this as part of my responsibility as the chairman of this institution, this House of Elders, to convey to the people what has happened, what has not happened, what is expected, and what we should do in the future. That is the purpose of this hereditary address by the chair. It happens always.
And chairman also informed the House of Rajya Sabha Television crossing the 2 million subscribers mark this month. He said that with this, the Rajya Sabha Television has become the fastest growing television channels of the country.
I have also a small good news. The Rajya Sabha TV is a property of the house. I am happy to inform that the Rajya Sabha TV on the 4th of this month crossed 2 million mark in terms of YouTube subscribers and has emerged as one of the leading channels, has grown 5 times since then. This reflects on the interest of the people in the proceedings of the house and related content.
The Comptroller and Auditor General report on the capital acquisition in Indian Air Force on Rafael fighter jets deal was tabled in Rajya Sabha on Wednesday. The CAG report said that the deal negotiated by the NDA in 2016 was 2.86% cheaper than what was negotiated by the UPA in 2007. The report compared 2007 and 2015 purchase agreement using the price of 18 fighters that were to be bought in a flyaway condition in the 2007 deal. And that's all we have for you in this edition. Thank you for watching. Namaskar.